Which was the most desirable item during the lockdown? And I'm not talking about groceries or medicines. It's alcohol.
Bhai, kya mahila, kya purush, sabhi log theke ke bahar line mein lage dikhai diye.
If you're interested to learn about the alcohol space, then we have this one company as a case study for you today, which is emerging. It's actually a small cap stock. So if you're ready, let's get started. But before we start, I need you to comment right now, the alcohol industry is good or bad, because I think we can learn a lot from each other. And I will read every single comment, so comment right now. Now, alcohol is injurious to health. There's no doubt about that. We are just analyzing this company from an investing point of view. So don't hate me if you hate alcohol. It's just an analysis. The name of the stock is Globus Spirits. It started in 1993. It's a small cap company in the beverages alcoholic sector. The one unique thing about this company is its 360 degree value model, which means that it starts all the way from distillation, all the way to bottling and even distribution, which means that this company does everything on its own, also called frontward and backward integration, which means they get to do higher margins, they get to have multiple businesses, and it of course affects profitability. And this is important for the alcohol industry because alcohol shows a lot of volatility. So if you're able to make money apart from just the alcohol consumption, it just stabilizes the business a little bit. So let's understand the business model, but remember guys, you can't and should not invest in a single company. You should first create a portfolio with a defined, tested strategy before you invest. Investing in small caps is pretty dangerous. So unless you have a proper portfolio, proper strategy, we have a bunch at learnapp.com. Please check them out. The first lesson is free. The business is divided into two parts. You have the B2B side and the B2C side. So let's start with B2B, specifically manufacturing, which is about 57% of the revenue. First, we'll talk about their bulk alcohol business. In the bulk alcohol business, this company is the largest grain-based extra neutral alcohol manufacturer. Now, extra neutral alcohol, or called ENA, is the primary raw material to actually create alcohol. So not only do they create their own end beverage, they also create the raw material to create any alcohol. So this means they're able to supply this to a lot of Indian-made foreign liquor manufacturers, actually some of the top brands. It has presence in Rajasthan, Haryana, Bihar, and even West Bengal. For any B2B business, you have two levers to actually improve to get your margins to become better. The first is that your selling price could increase, and the second, that your volume increases. This chart actually shows us that the volume of liters is increasing, but also the realization, that's the price per liter, has gone from 44 to 53, which means it's able to increase its price, yet be able to sell more liters to other businesses. The second business within B2B is franchisee bottling. Now, the business of alcohol means they're producing alcohol, right? So the actual United Spirits or ABD, for example, don't produce their own bottles. It's actually outsourced. So Globus actually does this for ABD, known for Officer's Choice, and United Spirits, which includes Johnny Walker, Black Dog, or McDowell. So this is a different business just built on bottling. Now, in this chart, we can see the bottling volume is increasing. That means it's able to produce more bottles. But check out 2021. There was actually a fall in the number of bottles produced. But notice that line on top. That's the bottling fee. It was able to increase the price of the bottling fee from 50 to 63.6, compensating for that loss in the bottling volume. This is good. Companies, especially B2B companies, which can control price, means that their company is pretty good and needed within the ecosystem. The third business within B2B is byproducts. You know, the interesting thing about alcohol is that it's built from grains, and grains is something animals need.
Achcha.
feed. Globus produces animal feed supplements which are rich in protein and energy and can be sold to any company or organization which domesticates animals. Then you have CO2. Now, commercially, it's available as a high pressure cylinder gas, dry ice, or even more commonly used in refrigeration. So CO2 is also a byproduct that is sold by Globus. And finally, we can see this chart over here of what the total operating income is only from byproducts. You won't see any growth here, but it's almost stable at a certain level, which means it's able to use the waste, also called byproducts, and actually sell it to other people. All right, let's talk about the consumer business. Remember, their consumer business is only 43%. Now, it is one of the largest Indian-made liquor players. I can see here they have various local brands. They also work with other premium brands like Unibev, and they've also started production of sanitizers. Now, this is interesting that they've turned the lockdown into an opportunity because sanitizers require alcohol. All right, so now let's do the numbers. You know, I love this part because we can actually see how the company is doing with numbers. Let's start with peer comparison. The first thing you'll notice is that out of all the peers, Globus is pretty small. So if they do their business right and expand, they have a lot of growth ahead of them. The next thing you'll notice is that it has a low PE. Because this is a small cap company, it's possible a lot of people, a lot of brokerages, a lot of investment banks or hedge funds just don't track this company. That's why the PE is low. And then trading is only 3 times the book value. Others are 10 or 11x. Then you have the highest ROE in comparison to peers. This is a good thing. Capital efficient businesses that put back profit and give a high rate of return on that capital base means the business is being run properly with the mind of shareholders in mind. And this is a high ROE business. Good in my books. If you didn't understand any of these financial ratios, we have a course for beginners on how financial ratios work. Check it out, sign up on Learn App. There's a link in the description and you can see the first lesson absolutely free without even signing up. All right, guys, so now time to see the financials. The first thing we see is the top line, that's the sales. So here we can see that the sales is constantly increasing. Generally, of course, that is a good thing. You'll also notice that the operating profit margin is increasing. This is important because you want either the cost of the company's raw materials to be decreasing or the price to be increasing. I think in both, this company has some power in both sides. So that's why the operating profit margin is increasing. You'll also see that the PAT, that means the profit after tax, has gone from 7 crores to a massive 141 crores. I think this is the magic of small companies, right? Like they give 1000x, 100% returns over the PAT pretty in a small period of time. So that's interesting. You'll also notice that the EPS is also growing. Now, obviously, when you have net profit increasing, the EPS, that's the earning per share, also increases from, in this case, 2 rupees to 48.9. That's just mind-blowing. That's actually pretty good. But what does this mean, right? Another set of things that you should look after looking at these financials is, what's the ROCE? Generally, anything above 15-20% is considered good. The ROCE here is 32.6%. That's great. There is a reduction in the debt, bringing the debt-to-equity ratio to 0.24. Anything below 1 is considered good. Below 0.5, you can think of it as almost zero debt. Then you have the improvement in the operating cash flow situation, right? What you want is that the business to have some free cash flow. In this case, it's actually increasing, which is a good thing. Another thing we could probably look at is the shareholding pattern. So here I can see that the promoter's stake has increased since 2018. Generally, this is a good sign that the promoters don't want to liquidate and continue to invest in the business, continue to hold stake in the business. There is zero promoter pledge, which is again very good. And the FII and DII holdings are negligible. Of course, this makes sense, right? Because it is a small cap. I'm sure not a lot of people actually track this, which means that this could be a really good or a really bad company. But a lot of FIIs, DIIs don't track this company. So what are the future prospects? You know, for small companies, it's very difficult to know what the future holds because they're not leaders in their industry yet. But we can speculate, which is what we're doing in this video. We can see that the company has a joint venture with Unibev that's launched 3 IMFL liquor brands in the prestige and above category. So that's something you should figure out. Do you think that category is increasing? Do you think that this joint venture would help, etc.? And because it's in the slightly premium category, the margins will be slightly better than in the lower category. The second thing you could think about is that they're slowly building up a franchisee in key territories. So again, you should research whether doing that is a good way to scale or not. The riskiest thing you can do as an investor is pick 1 or 2 stocks and hope that they'll hit the moon, giving you a profit. That's not going to happen, guys. What you need is 2 things. 1, a portfolio, and 2, a set of rules which tell you how to select the stock, when to enter, when to exit at a loss, when to exit at a profit. So overall, over a long period of time, even if a few stocks don't do well, you can still create wealth. We have a few courses on LearnApp that you can check out. Portfolio strategies we call investing strategies. The first video, the first lesson is free, so do check it out. We're also trying really, really hard to push out great content on YouTube. So please support us. You can check out these 2 videos next. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you enjoyed this, please put a comment and encourage us so we can push out more content your way.